Hey, welcome back, Gary Brown Forging On. I got a small welding project, just fabricating, not really blacksmithing. So this won't be a blacksmithing one, but it'll be some welding stuff. Just anything fun in the shop, that's what I like. So, and so this is what I'm gonna be making. And what happened is I got approached by a guy I know at church. He's got a camper. He pulls behind his pickup truck. So he apparently lives up on a hill, from what I understand, and he uses his tractor to pull his camper around in the around his house, because to come up that hill, apparently his truck's on two-wheel drive and has a hard time pulling that big camper up there. But he doesn't have anything to hook it to, I guess, on the front. I don't know, I've never seen his tractor. So he puts a ball on his drawbar on the back, and then he just hooks his camper up to it and then pulls it up with that. But problem is, them drawbars are real low to the ground, so when he hooks the trailer onto it, it drops that front end down, and then the feet only go up so far or something. I don't know. He just says something on the front drags. So he asked if I could make him just a 6-inch high extension on top of that drawbar. So I got a piece of 3-inch square tubing. It was just a cut off piece. It was only like 10, 11 inches long. And it's 3 inches outside dimensions, heavy wall square tubing, and it's got a little over 2.5 inches inside measurement. And then I had some old plate, and I used it, and I'm going to cut the top piece out, like the tongue. The 3 inches high was a little too high. I was worried about it wobbling too much, so I'm actually going to cut out an inch strip on both sides, which I'm going to cut the seam that's in there out. And then I'm going to sandwich it down to where I only have maybe an inch and 3/4 inch high, where it's supposed to be like 1.625, so it's just a little enough slop to go on to it. And then I'm going to cut off a chunk, and I'm going to cut off another chunk. The piece I cut off, I'm going to flip up on top. And then I got this 5/8 inch plate, and I'm going to put a plate on top. And I don't have anything to drill 1-inch hole. I don't have a 1-inch drill bit. And I'm just doing this for free. And so I'm not gonna go buy a 1-inch drill bit and try to go through 5/8 thick steel. So I just cut it with a torch. It's not the best. I cut it with a torch, and then I used an ID grinder, which is like 1.5 inches or 1.25 inches, maybe 1.25 inches. And just kind of worked it in the best I could to get it to work. Anyway, here's the process. Y'all enjoy. There's gonna be some torch cutting, some welding, and then finally paint it, and now just give it to them. So y'all have a blessed day, and we'll talk to you later. Bye.